to have needs, to have pains, to have trials, and even crises in life. It's not abnormal. It is very much part of being a human person, experiencing our finiteness, the effects of sin, and our limitation as human beings while on earth. So we should not feel bad. We should not feel as though we are living a life of misery, full of so much problems, the world and people are against us. Why should accidents and illness happen to us? Has God abandoned us? Worse still, is God punishing us? All these ways of thinking and feeling may be understandable because the pain can be unbearable. When the pain continues for a long time and when they are excruciating and there does not seem to be any light at the end of the tunnel, we begin to lose hope in ourselves, in any solution, and even in God. Well, such is the tendency of the human person. We have to remember that we are not only human beings like any other creatures existing on this earth. We are created by God in His image and likeness. As in the opening hymn, God says to us, "You are mine. Do not be afraid. I call you by name and I will lead you home." Meaning to say that whatever pains and trials of this life, it is part of this earthly journey, but there is a home, the eternal home, where our destination lies. The journey may be painful, but if we are clear of the final goal and home of where our faith will lead us, then we are called once again to renew our faith in God, in spite of and in and through the pains and the challenges, the concerns and the worries of life. To have the gift of faith is truly a great blessing. Because without the gift of faith, we are left to our own resources to manage our problems in life. Who can we turn to when we face problems? We are blessed if we have families and loved ones who give us that strength we need, who accompany us in our illness and care for us in our old age. But human beings can only do so much for us. How much can another person do for us? The pain is within us. It's like a mother who sees her child crying because of some pain and illness. The mother's heart is broken, seeing the child suffer. And the mother wishes that she can absorb the pain of the child, but she is helpless. In many ways, God sees our pain. He says, "You are mine and I love you." But God, in many ways, is helpless. We have to help ourselves and become people of faith to believe that God has not abandoned us, that God is within our pain and our suffering. When we have the eyes of faith, there will never be total darkness, because God is present to us Even though we may not see him and may not feel him, we must believe and hold on to the truth that because he loves us, because he willingly died for us, for our salvation, he will never abandon us to the evil ways and the trials of life that destroy our faith and our relationship with him and destroy the gift of eternal life. There are preachers who proclaim our need to have faith in God and tells us that as long as we have faith in God, no worries. Everything will be wiped away. You have no more problems in life. Everything will be fine as long as you love God and have faith in him. Is it true? Yes, it's true. However, it's not the complete picture. Just on its own is to preach a gospel whereby God seems to be a magical formula, that as long as we believe in him, there will be no longer pains and trials of life, which is not true. Why is it not true, and why is it not the complete picture? It is because the complete picture is first. Jesus, rejected by the world, crucified by his enemies, and only then, 3 days later, he rises from his death and then proclaims and witnesses to the fullness of the gospel of the resurrection and eternal life. We cannot bypass Calvary to get to resurrection. This means that the Christian faith, while it is a gift from God, is not a magical formula that is privileged only to us believers, and the rest of the world are condemned to death and to hell if we do not believe in Jesus. That is furthest from the truth. God came to save all. God came to be part of our lives, and he will always be part of our lives, regardless of the pains and the trials of life. He will be with us faithfully. But we must do our part. We must recognize him. We must embrace the Jesus who carries the cross and who is suffering. Not only the Jesus of the resurrection, and try to avoid and find a shortcut to life and our faith and love for God. It's like a person saying, I love you as my spouse, but I'm not willing to make the needed sacrifices, the pains. When you are in trouble, don't ask me to help. Is that love? No. Part of the committed love is the sacrifice, the selfless sacrifice to accompany, to be with, to console the pain and the suffering of the person we love, as much as we can. In the same way, God who loves us, do not abandon us. He's always there with us. This is the essence of our faith. And when God comes into the world to be fully human like us and yet divine, he lets us know for sure that he understands our suffering. He feels our suffering. He knows what suffering is all about. Rather than a theoretical or theological speculation that God loves us and feels for us, God himself, to prove to us his love, become one of us and suffers and dies for us. And we must never forget, therefore, that as we are blessed to be given the gift of faith, we must not lose hope. We must continue to beg God for that faith that is beyond the peace of our hearts, that looks for consolation, that looks for the magical formula for God to wipe away all our problems in life and to heal all our illnesses and worries and problems. That's not God. At least not, it's not Christ who we believe in. So we are people of faith gathered to embrace the Paschal mystery. And Jesus says, He's truly the Lamb of God. God is real and God is in our lives. The first letter of St. John in today's first reading tells us that God loves us and we are His children. What we are going to be in the future, we may not know yet, but we will become more like Him. Meaning to say, when we get beyond this world, we discover the infinite glory of God in the next world, that's the fullness of life. Until we get there, we do not yet comprehend the fullness of life. But our faith in this world must have that dimension of the spiritual and the mystery of God in our lives. Not everything has to be solved logically, simplistically, in the way we want God to solve them. Let us pray for the grace of maturity to be that adult who dares to embrace the cross as Jesus embraced, to even embrace the pain and the suffering. But the pain and suffering with God can never crush and destroy us, because we are not only just embracing the pain, we are embracing the cross of Jesus. And with Jesus, there will be redemption, there will be peace, there will be strength in spite of the pain, through the pain, because of the pain. We all know that when we want to build and grow and be more fully committed in any relationship, we need to experience the pain that builds relationship, strengthens relationship in times of crisis. Then the relationship becomes strong and unshakable. It is the same with God. Let us pray that God, who has gifted us this new year that is ahead of us, wants us to be renewed in our faith. Yes, in and in spite of the pains and the challenges of life. We must believe in a wholesome God who is merciful. We begin with ourselves by asking God for the grace and the wisdom and the humility to accept our faults, our failures, and our sinfulness. It is the clearest way of the Spirit working in our hearts. When we dare to admit before God that we are sorry, that we have sinned, we have done wrong, with the sincerity of heart, God will heal. God will empower us with the strength. God will enlighten us in our earthly journey. Then we will find peace, the true peace and the true strength that God wants to give us during this year and the coming years. Life, therefore, is not about having no problems. Life is about having God at the center of our lives, living in His ways, trusting in His ways, in the maturity of our love for Him, that is willing to bear the cross and find the true peace and consolation of God in spite of the pain and the challenges. The superficial way of living our faith is to say to ourselves, when we have pain and problems in relationship, in families, or in illness, God has abandoned me. That's an emotional feeling. Faith is deeper. Mystery of God is deeper. It is about everlasting life that exists already in our heart, that waits to unfold itself when we take the last breath of our earthly life. Let us pray tonight that our faith will be renewed, that our faith become more mature, that we dare to surrender and embrace whatever comes our way in life, because we believe and are renewed in our faith tonight, in particular through the Sacred Heart of Jesus, that God's compassionate love will never fail. And we will find the true peace of God in and through the challenges and the pains of life. I'd like us to ponder on these challenges for a few moments and ask God for that light, that wisdom to live this year more fully in His ways, His will, and in His love.